Yeah, what's up YouTube? This is Last Humans Garage coming at you. This is an all-ages car channel. Just kidding. All right, let's see what this video's about. In this one, we're going to be testing that magical tweeter that I told you about a few days ago. I wonder if I should do a wait. Nah, not right now. Okay, so your stock 3-inch, right? It isn't a tweeter, your dash speaker, 2015 Harman Kardon, by the way. That's important here. Because they do make a wiring harness for this Harman Kardon, but they do not make a wiring harness for the non-Harman Kardon. At least that's what I read. Maybe if you can prove me wrong, good for you. So I did find the Metra kit, and I did order it from Crutchfield. Now, I wouldn't have ordered it there. It's the only place, seriously, that I could find it. And you can see it is a match. Looks like it'll be good. It's a Toyota adapter, of course. This stuff is all, you always just experiment with this stuff. Who knows? So, pretty much right there. We're gonna try and plug this into the dash. Go into the high-end crossover, which is very heavy, through the inputs, really nice screw terminals there. Then we're going to come out to a tweeter at 0 dB for now, and a nice long cable, all quick disconnects, just for my test rig, you know, until I figure out what I want to do on that. I wonder if this would go right into that when all said and done, or if I have my connectors backwards. I didn't even think about that. Looks like I have it backwards. Oh well. Anyway, I'm just gonna put one in and see. I don't expect it to sound killer because there's just no way. The Harman Kardon uses a DSP amplifier somewhere. It's not in the head unit with the Harman Kardon. And with all its calibrated ohms, octaves, orders, crossovers, there's just no way it's gonna be right for this. But I just want to hear it. What I dream of is that it's about the same loud and much better sounding, of course. But I just don't think that's very possible. But we're about to find out. I'm going to put this on the driver's side. And I'll just eat the copyright on this. I'm going to put on like some, probably some Rush, just some of my cleanest music. And then go left to right and see if it works at all. And this crossover should protect it at least, even if it's the wrong everything. It's going through and being filtered here, so it should protect it, worst case, even if it doesn't even work. Now I do have a sheet of quarter inch HDPE, whatever, polyethylene. And I'm gonna, I'll make an adapter later if this even works. So my rig is set up. We're gonna come out of the tweeter harness right here, in there as we saw, out to the tweeter, which I gently laid, just held up on the edge, in the stock location. Let's see. I mean, I'm super excited. Until this doesn't work, then I'll just be all, dang, whatever. Turn this on, make sure the volume's down, find something good here. Off the AC. I don't want to listen to lithium. So I have to find a good, let's see, I'll do USB, there we go, Rush. So far I can barely hear the Pioneer tweeter. This tweeter is much more overpowering. Like I said, it's matched for the system properly. But I'm gonna have to do some left-rights here too. Yeah, that tweet is not giving me enough at all. Sound position. This is the Pioneer only. I can hear it now, but it probably should be louder. Oh, come on, I need some music. Let me just find the good song. So far, it isn't looking good, as we thought. Come on. Jesus Christ. One more. Here. That's a failure so far. There's a lot better imaging, which there should be on a DSP amp, on the right side, the stock side. There's almost nothing in this range over here. And as soon as I put it here, it sounded more like a stage again. So that's a fail first. I know this set needs an amp in all 10 senses and purposes. You need an amp for this. I know that. You don't need to all post that. I'm just experimenting, you know, trying it out. I want to try one more thing here before I shut down the test. I'm going to carefully bypass the crossover and go tweeter straight to here because it is active crossed at the DSP and see if that makes a difference at all. All right, no, even without the crossover, it is better, but it still doesn't have anything close to the impact of the stock one properly ohmed out for the whole crossover system. I'll let you hear it real quick. You're not going to be able to probably hear a difference. Let me find sound. What are we at right now? This is the Pioneer side. Now I'm going to go stock side. The tweet is a little better, but it's missing a lot of frequency. So you kind of get the idea there. Actually, it isn't bad without any of the without the passive box in there. But I'm not going to risk those tweeters like that because this is my favorite set of all time. I'm going to save them for a special day when I get an amp someday and not risk blowing them with all these funky frequencies I'm throwing at it and funky ohms and resistances in there. But it was an interesting test. I don't really see an amp coming anytime soon, so that's kind of long in the distance. But, you know, someday I wouldn't mind getting an amp in here. And, of course, I'd have to get a new deck. And maybe, I think those Pioneers would fit in here from what I hear from a guy that has ADS that are 3 inches deep. These are 2 5/8 inches deep. So I think with the proper spacer, maybe 1 1 1/4 1 1/2 spacer out of the door, and maybe trim the back of the grill, any of the fins, I think we could probably fit. But as I said, that's a pretty big project. There's definitely no money in the till right now with all the house stuff going on. So I'm very happy I snagged them. Now I'll just wrap them up in a safe place and save them for a rainy day. All right, thanks for watching the test with me. See you later.